Hi, I'm Jake.
And I'm Amber.
And this is My Next Hobby.
So today, for our project, we're doing something with the CNC machine, but it's going to be a little different from the things we've done before.
One of the first things I did when we got the CNC machine, like, put together was I connected a pen up to a little mount so we could just, like, draw stuff with it. It was kind of like a fun thing to just test to make sure that a lot of things functioned without using a high-powered or router to, you know, cut through stuff, but it kind of got the gears turning a little bit for you, at least, of like some things that you could use it for.
So I've been doing a little bit of sewing, not so much this summer, but I kind of got into it earlier this year. Instead of having to like buy fully printed patterns or like go to a copy shop to get full size ones printed, I've done a lot of just like printing out PDF patterns at home, and those come in like individual sheets that you have to print out, cut out, tape together yourself, and it's a super long, like, drawn out process, but it just takes so long and it's so tedious and I hate doing it. So when I saw like using that, basically using the CNC machine as a big printer, it came to mind that what if we use that to print out big patterns so I don't have to cut and assemble a million little pieces.
We kind of talked about it, and Amber had a pattern that she was working on a few months ago, and we took a look at it. And, you know, a lot of them come as PDFs, which is good because a lot of PDFs are like vector graphics already. The first one we took a look at was just not going to work as far as being able to use the CNC.
Yeah, it was a more like traditional style sewing pattern. So if you're not familiar with sewing, basically the patterns you get usually have a ton of different sizes on one printout. To differentiate the sizes, it's usually different like solid lines, dashed lines, dotted lines, and you can usually like hide the different layers and stuff, but unfortunately, at least with the one I was using, it did not at all work well with using it to draw on the CNC machine.
Yeah, especially dashed and like dotted lines. Like, you think, oh, like that's not a big deal, but with a, you know, with a plotter or like a CNC device, like what the other thing it was doing is basically drawing each dash as like a little rectangle.
Yeah.
It would just take forever to cut those out. So we were really looking to see if maybe we could find some other patterns that are more of a straight line, a straight path that can be drawn out much easier.
Because we tried to do a little bit of being able to convert those dotted and dashed lines into a solid one, and we just, at least in the efforts we've put so far, we couldn't find a good way to convert those easily and keep it accurate, that it would still be accurate to the initial pattern. So then in kind of trying to figure out how we could make this work with drawing out the sewing patterns, I came across people who used projectors to basically project onto the fabric or onto paper and cutting it out from there. They used like projector specific patterns where instead of having the dotted or dashed lines, they were all different colors, they were solid lines, which would meet exactly what we needed to be able to print it or draw it out with the CNC machine. So none of the patterns I already had met that, like none of them were projector specific, so I did a little bit of sleuthing and found these free patterns from the Victoria and Albert Museum in London. They have this cool little like interactive section of their website where they've got free plans for different projects that relate to exhibits they have previously or currently have on display. So this was related to, I think it was a Mary Quaint exhibit, I might be saying that last name wrong, but it's related to this fashion exhibit, and so it's this free pattern to make your own little like 60s style mini mod dress. It perfectly matched what we needed because instead of having dotted and dashed lines, they were all different colors. And so we decided this would be a perfect one to use to go ahead and give this a shot and see if I can make my own sewing patterns with the CNC.
This pattern worked really well. I imported the PDF into Illustrator and I was able to separate all the different layers out. I picked the specific size layer that Amber needed, and I don't think I had to tweak a whole lot. The only thing I really needed to do was split it up into different groups. So that we could cut them out on the paper that we have.
Yeah, the paper we used was, I actually bought it like in a bulk box off of Amazon. It's actually like medical paper, like it's the sheet stuff that you would find on like tables at doctor's offices. It's really nice for tracing things because it's like super thin. It's a little bit fragile, so you kind of have to be a little delicate with it, but it's great for tracing stuff, and it wound up being perfect for this. Like, it's great for making sewing patterns from.
So the work surface for the CNC is about 24 by 48 inches. We were able to use the, you know, the 18 width and then pretty much the whole length of the machine to draw on. So I just had to split up the individual shapes that needed to be cut out into a few different kind of groups that fit onto those that paper. And then I also had to get a flat board without any holes in it because the work surface on the CNC has all the holes cut in it for like the clamps and stuff like that.
From there, like that was all really the stuff we had to buy. We did wind up kind of taping the paper down. Originally, we just had it weighted down on each end. As it was drawing, it was kind of pulling at the paper. So all we did was take some just clear packaging tape, tape it kind of gently down on the sides, and it worked fine.
The other issue that I ran into was just the original drawing method I used when we first set up the CNC. It had a regular pen, like a clicky pen, that I zip tied to this little mount, and it mostly worked. The zip ties like didn't hold it on super strong, so the pen would kind of like do this sometimes. And I was just having a couple other issues. I also discovered that there is one little spot on the CNC bed that is just like slightly lower. There's like a little dip. Like, every time it would draw over this one spot, it just wouldn't draw. So I kind of started from scratch and redesigned that mount, and also bought some little pens that are meant for plotter machines for drawing. I 3D printed this mount so it would hold that pen in a little bit more sturdy. So I got all that, hooked it all up. It drew much better, but the low point on the CNC bed was still a bit of an issue. I was able to mostly work around it by basically redrawing a couple spots.
Yeah.
But I think if we start doing this more, I need to figure something out to either level the bed out more or allow the pen to kind of flex a little bit better to give it some more pushing power. But yeah, after I got all the kind of initial issues worked out, it was probably only like an hour or two of time rolling out the paper, letting it draw everything, cutting the paper, rolling it up, doing that a few more times. We had to do four different jobs of it drawing out the shapes.
Then I just kind of went ahead, like I cut them out. I haven't actually sewn anything with it, so I'll probably put together a second video at some point once I get around to doing that, just to kind of show that, hey, this actually worked and I was able to make clothes out of this. Yeah, like it was really pretty straightforward, and I think like, even though this one time it was like a lot more work on the upfront, now that we kind of know how to do this, this is gonna be a huge time saver for me for like making patterns in the future and being able to just like really easily print these out with the CNC.
Beyond that, there's a lot of other things that I at least could use it for. If there's something I'm ever designing where I just wanna print out a mock-up of, you know, the shapes or something like that, and it's larger than a regular sheet of paper, I could just, you know, get a large paper and just have that draw that out. Do some kind of art with it if we wanted to as well, you know?
We can't draw, but the CNC can do it for us.
Spirographs and all that kind of stuff.
Oh, now I'm into it.
So, we could make like crazy patterns using, you know, different colored pens and things like that. So I don't know. I think there's a lot more we could experiment with it now that we've kind of dipped our toes in the water, as
the kids say.
As the kids say. I will post the STL files for the plotter pen mount that I made on Thingiverse, and I'll put a link below. And I'll also include a link to the pens that I bought as well, in case you want to do this yourself with an MPCNC.
And if you're looking for the same sewing pattern that I'm using, we'll have that link down below as well. Like I said, it's totally free, which is really cool.
But I think that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave a comment if you have any questions, or if you've done something similar yourself and have some suggestions, or know of places where there are some patterns that would be easier to convert to have draw out.
If you like this video or found it helpful or it entertained you, then don't forget to hit the little like button down below, and of course subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. Thanks so much for watching.
Bye.